Hello everybody, welcome to WineActually TV, Malaysia's first wine TV. I'm your host, Wilson J Q Quah. And today's a Friday, and this morning I just took my wine exam. Okay, it's a paper set by the Wine and Spirits Education Trust all the way back in London, and it's for people who are quite interested in increasing their knowledge in kind of wine. There are different levels. There are like 5 levels which you can take. Well, today I took mine in Hallett's College. Okay, well, actually, you know what, Sean? If there are any of you out there who are interested in taking this kind of exams, let me know. You know, get me on Twitter, get me on my phone, get us on the office phone, whatever method you can get to us, email. We're gonna let's pull some people together so that we could get some special deals with Hallett's College. You know, that's the show. Yeah, I think that's quite good for the whole knowledge kind of thing. What's going on there? Anyway, today we're gonna taste some Barossa Shiraz. Background on Barossa Shiraz. Barossa Shiraz over the past few years have been gaining some very good reputation. It has been known to become the prime Shiraz producing region, not only in Australia, no, it's gonna be the premium Shiraz region in the world. Okay? We're talking about, when you talk about Shiraz, Barossa Shiraz, it's on a category of its own. We're thinking about things that the wine's going to be very full-bodied, it's going to be very high in tannins, sort of like medium kind of acidity kind of wine. But generally, the wines are not shy at all. It's going to be, you know, the moment you smell it, in my back of my brain before I taste this bottle, I'm going to be thinking, you know, the wine, it's going to be bursting into my face. The flavor is going to be like, you know, alcohol is going to be rushing through my nose. So yeah, I'm quite excited actually. Today we're going to be tasting the St. Hallett Gamekeepers Shiraz Grenache. Sean, I'm going to zoom in on that. Is that okay? Can you see the Gamekeepers at the bottom? Yeah? Yeah. Yeah, this is actually a Shiraz Grenache kind of blend. So I'm expecting, normally they in Shiraz, they blend it with something else. The more popular one nowadays is Viognier. Actually, they ferment it together actually. Let's see what's happening here. It says here, St. Hallett is a reputable name in Barossa, and they're generally quite proud of some of their wines. First block, or something like that. Anyway, oh shit. Oh. Let's taste some wine, because that's what we do here at WineActually TV. Put it right there. Drink me some wine. Off the back, you're gonna expect this kind of color, very dark kind of intensity actually. I think I pour a bit too much. This one's a bit lighter than usual. I would expect it to be much darker. See that? Very kind of purpley, kind of a dark, intense kind of color, and that's very characteristic of Shiraz. Now, the first thing you notice when you pour yourself a glass of Shiraz is that you 1 feet away, you already get the alcohol kind of smell, you know. Best served at room temperature, which is about 17 to 18 degrees Celsius. And let's do a bit of sniffy sniff. Sniff. Gary, you're watching that. Oh, this is a very interesting kind of nose. I'm picking up some dark berries, some cassis, some black currants, ribena for you, and also a bit of vegetal kind of component, very, very vegetable kind of smell, probably some cabbage, very gamey also, you can smell like meat, like, you know, raw piece of beef stick, and then you just kind of smell it. A little bit of the kind of smell, you get a bit of pickles actually, bit of pickles, a little bit of blueberries, a bit of pepper, and that is very characteristic. Dark fruits and pepper are the two things that you should pick up when you're drinking a Barossa Shiraz, or in fact a Shiraz.
Yeah, some
yeah. After a while, it sort of like go away.
So yeah,
let's give it a whirl and sip in our mouth. Now what I got on my palate is definitely blackcurrant, ribena kind of flavor. I get a little bit of the pickle kind of flavor. The acidity is medium. It's not quite high, so that's very characteristic of it. And on the back of the label, I think it mentions something about medium bodied, but I think this is sort of like a medium full kind of bodied. And off the finish. Blueberries going on there, yeah, definitely. About still a good 12 seconds of blueberries in there. The taste thing that very savory. This is very kind of savory kind of wine. This actually goes well with meat, with duck, especially. We should actually do this with duck, and probably with a bit of a medium rare kind of steak. Tannins are generally quite. It's not very high, this tannin is.
Excuse me one more time.
Lots of blueberries and pickles in my mouth. A bit of raspberry as well. And tannins are very. I would say this tannins is quite. Very medium. Okay? This is not harsh tannins. I actually quite enjoy this wine, and I'm gonna give this wine and I'll give it an 88. You know, it's straightforward, definitely more complex than the Shiraz that I tasted last week, the Yellowtail Shiraz. That's it. So, what's the lesson of the day? Lesson of the day, if you're tasting Barossa Shiraz, don't always expect the characteristic kind of taste, because these people, what they're trying to do, the premium Shiraz region, they're trying to go back to their sort of that old style kind of viticulture, planting the wines, you know, not doing too much the wines, and just let nature take the course. So, signing off from WineActually TV, I'll see you next time.